How do you know if a prop firm is legitimate? Let's start by defining firms that aren't legit. Let's start by defining the word scam. When I looked at the word scam in the Merriam-Webster dictionary, I found the definition a fraudulent or deceptive act or operation, or to deceive or to defraud. Keep that definition in mind for the rest of this video. Let's get started. I'm about to tell you the story of my personal experience with a Trader Central white label prop firm. As you can see on the screen, Trader Central is both an individual prop firm and it's also a host, or a white label host, for other prop firms. And as you can see by their design choice, it definitely gives me extremely strong vibes of another prop firm that we recently discovered as a confirmed scam. The white label company that I was using for this particular video and the one that I end up passing was with Funded Academy. Now, if we scroll down on the Funded Academy website, if you scroll down here, I decided to try out the $200,000 account, so I paid about $800 for this particular challenge. As you can see on the screen, credit where credit is due, Funded Academy did a fantastic job at getting me the details right away, pretty much as soon as I paid for the challenge and got processed. And as you can see, they are using the Trader Central Brid demo as the broker, and they also did provide the download for the MT5 Trader Central Bridge right in the initial email. In fact, Funded Academy ended up sticking up for me, which I'll show you in just a little bit, but first I wanna show you what happened to my account. As you can see, I made a little over 9% gain, which is more than was required. I only need to make 8% per the white label rules. I did not break any rules whatsoever, and I even kept a consistent lot size throughout the whole challenge, even after I hit the profit target. But unfortunately, I was not allowed to continue for a reason I'm about to show you. I was messaging the white label prop firm company after I passed all the challenge within all the rules, and this was their response to one of my questions I asked. They said, "Hello, Blake, wanted to give you an update on your account. Unfortunately, the risk desk at Trader Central deemed your trading unsatisfactory due to making all profit in one trade. We're pretty angry about this as we feel your trading showed good risk management and capabilities, and it just demonstrates the nature of trading a high risk reward ratio strategy." After that, they basically explained how they ended up reaching out to the Trader Central risk team on my behalf, which I really appreciate. I'm about to show you. And they also offered me a free 100K account with their new program that's not white label, with just this one company alone. As you can see on the screen, this is a message sent from Funded Academy to Kyle, who works for the Trader Central risk team. And it reads as follows. "Hello, Kyle. You see from the trader's initial trades that he attempted to go for 5 to 10 RR trades, which ultimately usually reflects in a small win percentage. Therefore, it's expected for that account to go into some drawdown before hitting a trade that runs into a large percentage gain. The buildup was seen in steady equity increases as shown in good risk management and trade management. Following that trade, he remained within the 75% lot size limit. I'm a bit confused on how this trader doesn't demonstrate effective risk management and trading capability. If you get back to me on this, that would be great. Thanks." So this is summarizing it extremely well. I really appreciate Funded Academy for sending this message. I think they hit the nail on the head here. It's a really, really good explanation of how I was actually trading on this particular account. Even though Funded Academy had an excellently well-written email, they decided to pretty much disregard what he was saying, and this is what they said in response. They said the following, "Hello, please find below a risk review for Blake. The trader has no real buildup. Account was at a loss from these dates. Profit target was met in a single trading day as registered by the 12.6% increase in balance. Remainder of the trading period has no significance in account buildup. Recommendation, offer a retry." In my opinion, Kyle has absolutely no clue what he is talking about. I ended up using a 0.31 lot size for that particular trade that ended up making that much profit. I was holding that trade for an extremely long time. It had extremely good risk management, and I was not in very much drawdown at any point in time on this account. Unfortunately, Funded Academy isn't the only Trader Central white label prop firm out there. A couple others include BTD FX Funding, which I've already done a whole review on this one, so I'm not gonna go through them pretty quickly. I've also mentioned FX Seed on my channel before as well. And as you can see from their Trustpilot, they have 20 reviews and none of them are 2, 3, 4, or 5-star reviews. All 20 are 1-star reviews for this particular prop firm. Trend Following Fund, which I interviewed the founder of that particular prop firm a little while ago, and Blue Edge Financial, who has another YouTube channel as well. They own this particular prop firm. This is in no way a comprehensive list of all the Trader Central Fund white label companies out there. I'm sure there's many, many others as well. And I'm about to show you how you can identify if a company is a Trader Central Fund white label company or not. I'm gonna show you where to find this rule on Blue Edge Financial. By no means does this only affect Blue Edge Financial, it definitely applies to every single Trader Central white label that I've seen myself. If you scroll all the way to near the bottom in the FAQ responses section in one of the very last questions over here, it says, "If I complete all the trading objectives, is it a guaranteed pass? The answer to this question is going to be really key in finding out if a company is a Trader Central fund white label company or not. I'm not saying that every single company that says this is or isn't, but it is going to be a huge key in finding out if they are or not. And that answer is going to be if they do not allow it, or if they have a, if they mention a risk team. So that what this says here is Blue Edge Funding is partners with a private backer who funds our traders with real live capital. Therefore, the risk team, which we've seen that a little earlier, reserves the right to analyze a trader's trading strategy. And if they deem the trader are too risky, that trader will receive a refund on the account. However, this situation is rare as long as you follow our rules and guidelines. And then it cuts off there. I'm assuming they meant to say that you have no worries or something, but I have some evidence to suggest the contrary to that in just a little bit. The second most important thing to check if you want to find out if a company is a Trader Central white label company or not is look at their very specific parameters. Now, if you see that their exact parameters are almost identical to Trader Central, then that's another huge red flag. They are very likely going to be a same company as a white label company with Trader Central. As you can see on here, if they have an 8% profit target or a 4% verification and their max loss is 10 and 10, it's a 10 and 5 strategy, 30 days and 60 days for the challenge and verification, then it's very, very likely it is going to be a white label company. The third and maybe most effective strategy to find out if they are a white label company through Trader Central or not is if you just ask their customer service what their broker is. If they say their broker is a Trader Central Bridge broker, then that is going to be a huge red flag. It's extremely likely that they are indeed going to be a white label company with Trader Central. Now going back over to the main culprit of this whole thing, I'm on tradercentral.com, and as you can see, if we go to products and funding, so that's what we're talking about in this video, we go ahead and scroll down all the way down to their trading rules. If I go through every single one of these, you'll notice that the only time it's going to be mentioning the risk desk or anything similar to that is going to be in the group trading section. And it's going to be right over here, can I appeal a flag? So if they think that you're group trading and then you think that you're not, you can appeal that, and it says you can reach out to the risk desk and dispute the flag. It doesn't mention anything else about the risk desk whatsoever, about anything about you have to be inserted parameters, it has to be all this. It doesn't say anything else about that in this section. A couple other things to note though that I just thought was kind of interesting. A little typo here says you can review your subscription and your portal. I'm sure they meant to say in, not a big deal. Withdraw and drawdown limits. By the way, they have this 5% block rule. I just think that's terrible. This is a little side tangent. And also they don't allow hedging, expert advisors, or trade copiers. Since we couldn't find anything significant in the trading rules section, let's go ahead and scroll back up and go to the help center. Now, in the help center, it's pretty interesting. They have the questions and answers by product, so their fund, tokens, liquidity, and crypto. But on here, they also have a way to type in something. So we know we're trying to ask about the risk team. So I decided, let's go ahead and type in risk team, hit enter. And we can see that unfortunately, nothing comes up. So if you type in risk team, that's what we wanna know about, nothing comes up on their search bar here, which really sucks in my opinion. Let's go ahead and type in risk. And we see there's two different things that pop up here, both under the one-time fee plans, which is what I'm talking about right now. I'm not really talking about the monthly plans. I think paying monthly for a prop firm account, in my opinion, I don't like that whole idea, so I don't like that at all. So we're talking about the one-time fees only. And this one here, what are the risk reviews? So now we're on to the right track. Risk reviews are really key. Unfortunately, they only have a video, and as you can tell, if you can see, it's really small, so I apologize to anyone that has on a small screen now, but they have the old logo there, where it says Trader Central Fund in a very, very small old logo, and they have the video for that, which you can play here. I'll save you have to watch this video. It's really old and you can tell, I know I keep saying that, but the audio on the video is just really grainy and it just doesn't really explain anything too well. It's basically risk reviews for if you have any drawdown on a funded account. It doesn't really talk about what you need to be able to be funded in the first place. Since this still isn't what we're looking for, we have to go back over to the homepage, and unfortunately we can't search for this very easily. We're gonna go over to the Q&As by product, go to the fund section, and then we go to funding plans. That's how hard it is to see these hidden rules, okay? Then you can't be on the monthly plans, that's not what we're talking about. We have to switch over to the one-time fee plans because it's a whole different section. If that's how many clicks you have to get to just to see these rules. And as you can see in just a second, you'll be surprised by what these rules are. And then there's this FAQ here, under what conditions will I get promoted to a live account? This is so important, yet so hard to find on the website. You saw how many things I had to go through just to get here. And it states this, under what conditions will I get promoted to a live account? Within the evaluation stage, the risk team would require consistent trading each day that you trade with proper risk management in order to evaluate you properly before promotion onto the second stage, live funds. In some cases, your evaluation may be extended by the risk team in order to get a promotion to the second stage or live funds. If you do pass the evaluation, but your trading doesn't align with our risk appetite, you will be refunded an extra 10% compensation for your time and labor input. Now, that sucks. If you spend all this time and all this energy, all your risk, you risk the 100% of what you paid, where you might get just 10% extra back on top of your refund if the risk team, which as we already saw, they're not exactly the smartest people in the world in terms of knowing who's a good trader and who's not, they might say that you're not a good trader and then you would not be able to get your funded account. You just get a refund plus 10%. Now that really, really is absolutely terrible in my opinion. What does this risk team actually look for? So as you can see on the screen, and this is again, not the easiest thing to find, but I found an area on one of the white label sites where it discloses what they're looking for. I personally was not able to find this on the Trader Central site. I'm not saying it's not on their site. I just was not able to find this anywhere on their entire site. But it says, what are we looking for? And they want to see account consistency growth, slow and steady during the evaluation process. And these are examples of what they would like to see. So essentially, if your trading is a perfect straight line, you will get accepted. Awesome, nobody trades like that. But if you are perfect, then congratulations, you might be able to be trading with these guys. This is absolutely unrealistic trading styles that you can see in here. Yes, some people can do it. Yes, some people have done that. And yes, some people have received payouts from Trader Central, but this is so unrealistic in my opinion to be able to trade this perfectly. And these now showing some examples of equity curves that we were found to not be acceptable within our parameters. So we can see the first one here, which looks extremely normal. And that looks like a lot of accounts that I've had where it goes up and then kind of goes down a little bit, maybe a little ABC in there if you're those edit wave fanatics, and then it goes back up and finishes in profit. This looks pretty nice and good looking chart to me, especially this first one here. I don't see any problem with this kind of trading at all, in my opinion. The second one, I more understand if people just trade on one trade and it goes up, especially if it's high leverage or something, that maybe would be a little bit better of a reason, but it's still, if someone reaches it and they didn't break any rules, I think they deserve to continue and they should be able to get guaranteed funding if they follow all the rules that you have. The next one we see on here is one where they pretty much made a whole bunch of money at the end, and they also were pretty smooth about the whole thing, and then it's coming to a close and they decide to make a bunch of money at the end. And that this is something that people do all the time. So these are absolutely horrible examples. I am absolutely horrified to see these as being unacceptable options. I think that these traders, if they're able to make the goal and they were to follow the rules, they should be able to get their funded accounts. And that's my opinion. Unfortunately, I don't believe that I'm the only person that has been not able to continue with their account due to the risk team. As you can see on the screen here, this is an example of someone else who is messaging the Trader Central risk team, and it reads as follows. It says, "Dear Fernando," which again is someone else, not me, "unfortunately, we are not confident enough to promote you, being at most the gains to 10% previous came from what we see as over leveraging, and during an extended period, a profit of only $52 was made. We have refunded your subscription, find attached proof, with an additional 10% for time and labor input. We see you're up on your second account on stage two. We look forward to seeing you go live." So this is really interesting, just that they're even doing this to so many people. I know that Fernando and I are not the only ones who have been affected by this. So if this has happened to you, I would love to hear about it. Let me know in the comments below if a similar situation where a risk team said that even though you've passed and everything, you didn't break any rules, you still can't continue. And even if it hasn't happened to you, check the comments below, because that will be extremely interesting to see if there has been other people that something similar has happened to as well. I don't know that it's happened to other people, but I definitely strongly believe it has. So check the comments below if you want to see that. As you saw in this video, there's a ton of Trader Central white label prop firms. Some of them are no longer around, such as FXSeed, but some of them are ripe and going for the kicking, and they're still going on. If you want to know how easy it is to start your own white label with Trader Central, look at this. So if we're on our homepage on tradercentral.com, we go to products, and we don't click funding this time. Instead, we go over to liquidity. It says start your prop firm in 24 hours. It says we eliminate lengthy paperwork, legal complexity, and numerous fees. The backbone for prop firms. For ambitious founders around the world, we make starting a local fund as simple, borderless, and programmable as the rest of the internet. Personalized portal, which you can read about right there. They have a branding suite. All this information is very, very interesting. They have confidential and secure. Apparently, over 80 prop firms use Prime Bridges liquidity, which is absolutely an insane number. Then we have an FAQ over here as well. I'm gonna go through this pretty quickly. The only requirements that are listing in their FAQ to start your own prop firm is that you're at least 18 years old and you have a registered company. Those are the only requirements according to this article right here, that you have to do to access this liquidity. How long does it take? It's in between 24 hours to looks like up to 7 days, depending on if you have to do a whole bunch of complex things. And what happens after you apply, you'll be contacted within 24 hours. And then our partners from all around the globe accepted. It says yes, however, check locally just to make sure that it is applicable for you. So that's how easy it is to start your own Trader Central white label prop firm. As far as I've seen, Trader Central white labels are the only firms that I've seen that have this terrible rule. There may be others out there, but I haven't seen any other ones yet. To be clear, I am not calling Trader Central a scam just yet. I think there's been tons of people who have been able to been let through, get their fund account, and even receive a payout share with Trader Central. But knowing how few traders are ultimately able to pass any prop firm, and if a company lowers that number even more by using a risk team, then in my opinion has no clue what a profitable trader looks like, and to disqualify skilled traders after they pass without breaking any rules. And keeping the definition of scam in mind, I'd love to hear what you think in the comments about this company. However, please don't lose faith on the industry as a whole. There are a ton of excellent, legitimate prop firms that as long as you follow all the given rules and all the parameters and you're able to pass with those prop firms, they guarantee that you're able to continue on to further stages. Some of those include the Fund Trader, FTMO, Mint Funding, My Forex Funds, and so many others. There'll be a huge list of them in an upcoming video really, really soon. If you guys got any value out of this video, I'd really appreciate it if you guys hit the thumbs up button. It helps me out a ton, and it also shows me that you guys like this kind of content and wanna see more videos like this. If you guys wanna see a video where I go over the top 7 best prop firms, check out this video right here. It's my most recent one where I go over the most legitimate prop firms out there. As mentioned at the beginning of the video, everything mentioned in this video is in my opinion. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this company as well. Let me know in the comments below.